The title of the story is Cain and Abel. Cain and Abel were the sons of Adam and Eve. Cain was a farmer, Abel was a sheep keeper. One day they brought their offerings to God. Cain brought red tables, Abel brought remaining fat of sheep. God was pleased with Abel but was not pleased with Cain. God told Cain, Why are you sad, Cain? If you do what is right, good will be waiting for you at your door. Cain told his brother, let's go out to play. He took a stone and killed his brother. God said, why did you kill your brother? Listen, your brother's blood is crying out to me from earth. God banished Cain from the land of Eden. My moral is, never be jealous of anyone. As God always says, if you do what is right, good is always waiting for you. I'm trying more effort.
Good morning, church. My name is Bayo Dewale, and my favorite book of the Bible is Genesis. Genesis is the first book of the Bible, and it has 50 chapters. There's also a lesson from the story. It is that not to disobey God no matter what, because Adam and Eve disobeyed God by eating the forbidden fruit that God didn't tell them to eat.
Good morning, church. My name is Temilore Adeye, and I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible, Luke, Zacchaeus the Tax Collector. Zacchaeus was a short man who lived in a town. He was a tax collector, and he was. But when Jesus came to his town, he forgave his sins. So my lesson is forgiveness. Jesus can forgive you for any of your sins. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is Adeola Odejai, and I'm about. My favorite book of the Bible is Genesis. Genesis 1 to 3, about Adam and Eve. God made the sun, earth, and moon. And when he made that, he made the night, and he was very proud of his creation. Then he made Adam. Then he noticed Adam was lonely, and he made Adam to sleep. And he took one rib from Adam to make Eve. Then he introduced Eve to Adam, and they started getting along. One day, God said, you can eat of any tree except for the tree of good and evil. One day, Eve was talking to a snake, and the snake said, if you eat the tree, you'll be like God. So she ate it and gave it to her husband. Then they were both ashamed, and God found out and banished them from the Garden of Eden. My moral is never disobey God or you get negative consequences. Thank you.
Good day, church. My name is Tua Lewin, and my favorite book of the Bible is Psalm. Did you know that Psalm has 150 chapters? And it is my favorite book of the Bible because it shows the greatness of God, especially through thanksgiving. My favorite chapter of the book of Psalm is Psalm 91. It is a psalm of protection that shows God's true love for you. Praise the Lord.
Good morning, church. My name is Daniel. I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible, which is Daniel. Daniel is the 27th book, and Daniel has 42 chapters. I like Daniel because Daniel was a very powerful man and he believed in God in everything he does.
Good morning, church. My name is Tireni. I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible, which is Esther. Esther has 10 chapters. The reason why I like Esther is because of Esther helped the Jews and she always prayed. What I've learned from this is that you should help people and you should always pray no matter what.
Good morning, church. My name is Jaden Yobo. I'm 7 years old and I'm going to be talking about my favorite character in the Bible and my favorite verse in the Bible. My favorite verse is Matthew 4 verse 4. And it says, when Satan tried to tempt Jesus to do the wrong thing, Jesus said, "Man shall not live by bread alone, but by the word that comes out of God's mouth." Thank you.
Good morning, mommies and daddies. My name is Michelle Okolo, and I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible, 2 Chronicles, which is the 14th book of the Bible. It is talking about a great king named King Solomon. King Solomon was a son of King David. King Solomon built the temple of the God of Lord, which is instead of his father, King David. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Adachi Koeze, and I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible is Psalm. There are 150 chapters in Psalm. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is Mayamiko Opega, and I'm going to be talking about my favorite book of the Bible, which is Ruth. Ruth is the seventh book of the Bible, but even though it has four chapters, it's still a very interesting one. The reason why I like Ruth is because there's a woman named Naomi and another one named Ruth. And Ruth always took my Naomi's side, even though the Lord was making her life bitter by her husband and both of her sons being dead. But she still went back to Bethlehem with her. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is Ebubechukwu Eze, and I'm here to talk about Genesis. Genesis has 50 chapters, and I'm here to talk about it. Genesis talk about the creation of God and the creation of us, we humans. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is Aitobi, I'm going to talk about my favorite book in the Bible, Esther. The reason why it's my favorite book of the Bible is because she was brave, she was fearless, and she believed in God, and she set a very good example. And he only has 10 chapters. Thank you.
Good morning, church. My name is Kendra Fordman, and I'm here to talk about my favorite book of the Bible, which is 1 Kings. Jeremiah disobeyed God in many ways. One of the ways he disobeyed God was that he always worshipped idols. God was very angry and unpleased with him that he had to face a punishment. One of the worst punishments was that his son died. Jeremiah was very sad. And my lesson is that never worship idols. Thank you.
Because Esther was loved by the king. Thank you. of the Bible is Daniel Bataraki. And my favorite book of the Bible is Daniel, because my name is Daniel. And my favorite chapter of Daniel is chapter 1, verse 16. When Daniel went to see the king, and the king said, hold on a minute, then I'll see what your dream is. And also there's 12 chapters in the book of the Bible for Daniel. And I want to talk about a bit more. So even as a young age, it was very smart. And I want to talk a bit more about Daniel. And even as a young age, in when you start Daniel, you see, even as a young age, he was very smart. And two people and Daniel were thrown into the lion's den because of worshiping God. Then, but only Daniel survived. But some, and when the people who threw them inside the lion's den, when they fell.
Okay.
There is going to be a royal ball.
Royal ball.
Yes, royal ball. Yeah, 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 and yeah. There is going to be a royal ball. The king wants your best. Yes, your best. Cook your best dishes, wear your best clothes. It's time to celebrate. Hasten your steps. Tarry not.
Welcome to the Lord's banquet. This is the day that the Lord has made, for we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Eat, be merry, and enjoy yourselves.
Yay!
Tell us the things God has done for you.
God has been so good to me. I made an abundance of sales this year.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God has been so good to me. I bought acres of land. I bought the land in Lekki, Banana Island, and even in Parkview.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, God has been so good. I had triplets this year.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Feel free to speak.
I don't know about you, but this year has been very challenging for me. I had a lot of experiences that just made me feel like giving up.
Really? How's everything going on with you now?
I'm taking one day at a time.
Most importantly, give yourself time to grow.
I am learning to accept God being in my life, forgiving, and finally finding my peace.
Do you know you're a child of God?
And you know God loves you.
Stop being worried and anxious about life. Look at the birds. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns. Yet the heavenly Father keeps feeding them. I didn't know what much more than we did.
But you know we are here, which means we are victorious.
is for victory, because he lives inside of me. Jesus beat it in my heart, makes me want to sing. We are victorious, we are victorious. Jesus made us special, and his eye is glorious.
Jesus set us free, we are free indeed. We live in victory, and we always win. We are conquerors, we are champions. Jesus made us special, and his eye is glorious.
Yes, I believe we are victorious. Whenever I fall, I don't feel like crying.
It's okay to cry. It's okay to fall. Even when we feel bound, don't shake off the shackles because we are but Christ.
That showed up, we raised a chant.
God has given us victory. He has taken away all fears. What the enemy plans to do, God has turned it around for us. Now we rest, that's us a victor. Move us a victor. So clap us a victor. We have the victory. Now we rest, that's us a victor. Move us a victor.
at all he's able to do. All you need to do is to trust and obey in him.
God is awesome. See what he's doing. All we waited and prayed for has come to pass.
God is amazing. He's able to do wonders. He's able to do wondrous things if you just trust in him. It is a blessing to be part of this amazing family of worshippers and true believers.
God is good. Look at all he has done. And think of the hope that you have in his son. God is good.
And his mercy endures forever.
Cast all your burden and fears for he cares for you. Stay blessed and do not forget to pray always.
Thank you. Let's shout hallelujah. A louder hallelujah. That was a wonderful one. And let's give it up for our children. What you have seen is the result of months and months of practice and rehearsals. And at the Children's Church, we have tried this year more engaging than any other year to engage our children. All of the teachers you see, please, every teacher in the Children's Church, can you rise up and join me at the altar here? They have sacrificed their time. They have sacrificed their opportunity to attend the service and be blessed just to attend to our children. Please join me at the altar. Let's give it up for them. And our coordinator, Mrs. Olusoya. Where's Auntie Emma? Under the leadership of our coordinators, Mrs. Olusoya. Where's Mrs. Olusoya? Okay, so all of these wonderful women you see here have taken their time out for the past 1 year to instill discipline, instill knowledge, wisdom. Now, this year, we did something that we haven't done in previous years. We set out at the beginning of the year to instill the discipline of prayer in our children. So we noticed that over 7 months into that, or 6 months, we noticed that the fire of prayer was already built in them. So the days we wake up and say we don't want to do morning assembly, they insist that no, we must do morning assembly. They want to pray. They want to praise God. They want to do their praise and worship. And the feedback we've gotten from some of our parents is that some children come in the morning and wake them up and say, Mommy, Daddy, let's go and do praise and worship. So we thank God for the privilege to be used by God in that regard. So I want us on our seat right now to stretch our hands forward and bless and speak into their lives, speak the blessings of God into their lives, every one of them. As they serve God in this assembly, let God show up for them in their lives, in every aspect of their lives. For in Jesus' mighty name we've prayed. Over our children in this assembly, we will not cry over any one of them in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray in their own time, in their own generation, they will make a mark in their generation in the name of Jesus. Father, we decree that in this new year we are about to step into, the testimonies that we've recorded amongst them, the growth academically, spiritually, physically, we pray that growth shall be optimized positively in the name of Jesus. Father, over every family and household represented here, you will not cry over your children in the name of Jesus. Lord, we decree the spirit of excellence will rest upon them now and in their future in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for answered prayers. For in Jesus' mighty name we've prayed. Amen. Amen. Let's give them a round of applause.